The PSJA Library Department invites everyone to participate in the PSJA Reads Together program. Every 6 weeks, a book is recommended per grade group. Here are this 6 week's recommended books.
Hi, my name is Brenda Valdez.
Hi, my name is Abigail Garza.
We're in second grade at Garcia Elementary.
The title of our book is Chicks and Salsa
by Aaron Reynolds,
illustrated by Paulette Bogan.
The setting of the story is at the barn.
The problem is that the barn animals are tired of eating the same food every day.
The characters of the story are the rooster, the chickens, the ducks, the pigs, and Mr. and Mrs. New Thatcher.
We invite you to read this book at your school library. You won't believe the ending. PSJA is wild about reading.
PSJA Reads Together.
Catch the reading wave.
Read!
The aliens have landed! The aliens have landed!
No talking!
Sorry.
If you had to not talk for 5 minutes, the whole top of your head would explode. Boys never talk as much as girls do, ever!
You take that back!
Take what back? That girls are big blabberheads? No way, because they are. Everybody knows that.
You never have any trouble with yourself blabbing and blabbing every day. We all heard you.
And with this exchange of words begins the contest between fifth grade boys and girls at Lakeland Elementary School. Do you think you can go without talking for 48 hours? That's what the boys and girls in Andrew Clements' book, No Talking, agreed to do. What happens? Who wins? Want to know? Read No Talking by Andrew Clements. It is a featured title from the PSJA Reads reading list for this 6 weeks.
PSJA Reads Together.
Catch the reading list.
Read!
What?
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just this book, Everlost. It's like I can actually see the characters, Nick and Allie.
So what's the book about anyways?
Well, these two characters, Nick and Allie, get in a car accident and they're caught between life and death. They struggle to find their way out of Everlost and into the real world. Well, I don't want to ruin the excitement for you, but trust me, you'll love the book.
Well, he had to catch it during lunch because, you know, it's buzz about ring, so I'm just gonna see it to then.
Nick, Allie,
help.
Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Does anyone say no?
A simple misunderstanding can affect everyone involved.
And how the press may take it too far. This is exactly what happened in the book, Nothing But the Truth, by Avi.
When a student named Philip Malloy was suspended from his school, Harrison High, for singing along with the Star Spangled Banner. But was it patriotism, a practical joke, or a way to misbehave and get out of Ms. Norrin's English class?
Philip Malloy, I've told you many times before not to sing during the Star Spangled Banner. Now you go to the assistant principal's office right now.
However, the conflict may run deeper than anyone else may know, because according to Philip, Ms. Norrin is the one responsible for him failing her class.
So coach, I've been practicing every day for the track team, for the trials.
Okay, well, I'm glad to hear that. I need to take a look at your grades. You do know that there is actually a rule, a district rule basically, that says no pass, no play.
What? I don't know about that.
Yes, sir, correct. I actually have your grades here with me. I did see that there was a D in your English class.
What? Oh, it's Ms. Norwin's class. She doesn't like me. She failed me on purpose. It's her fault.
I'm sorry, I really can't do anything about that. That is the school rule.
It's all Ms. Norman's fault.
After being sent twice to the assistant principal's office, Philip Malloy was suspended from Harrison High.
Who do you think is right? Philip for trying to defend his patriotism, or a teacher trying to do her job?
What is the truth? Can it never be known?
Want to know what happens next? How about you go to your favorite library and ask for nothing but the truth and read along as PSJA reads together.
Catch the reading wave. Read.
Parents, students, and district employees, look for these books at your campus library, public library, or local bookstore, and remember, catch the reading wave. Read.